So, the process of creating an amazing Pinterest pin template is quite simple. First, make a list of all the keywords within your niche. Then, use Pinterest to find Pinterest pin template ideas. And finally, use Canva to create your own Pinterest pin template. Greetings everyone, Rylan here. And today I'm going to teach you how to create your very own Pinterest pin template from scratch. Let's get right into it. So the first thing to do is make a list of all the keywords you wish to rank for that are within your niche. So the niche I'm going to be choosing right now is the personal finance niche. So the most basic keywords in this niche will be something like how to make money, how to save money, investing basics, budgeting tips and tricks, best side hustles and passive income ideas. Now that I have a few keywords in my bucket, let's head over to Pinterest. What we need to do is go to the Pinterest search bar and type how to save money. So let's do that. How to save money. Hit enter. We need to find pins that look attractive and deliver the message properly. Our message is how to save money. So we need to find pins that are eye-catching and crystal clear in the message. On a quick look, I find this pin to be quite attractive. It states the message clearly, saying that 7 genuine ways to trick yourself into saving money. This is something that I might be interested in looking forward to. So let's keep this on hold. And even this is quite interesting. Okay. 35 realistic frugal living tips that will save you thousands. Eye-catchy title, creative Pinterest pin, and something which we can use for our future work. Now, I'm going to be repeating the same process for the remaining keywords. And then we'll catch on to the next step. If you're a graphic designer or a person who likes to brainstorm new ideas from scratch, you can totally skip this step and start creating your template. But for the majority who are probably doing this for the first time, getting inspiration from pins similar to your niche is a great way to creating your first Pinterest pin template and also a great way to grow on Pinterest. To design a pin template, we are going to head over to Canva. Canva is one of the best graphic designing tools to create stunning social media content for free. Its user interface is smooth and it has thousands of free and premium pre-made templates for you to choose from that can make your work 1,000 times faster. Instead of coming up with creative design ideas from scratch, you can use pre-made templates on Canva. Here's how you go about it. Let's say you want to make a wedding card and you're searching for a really good template. Here's how you do it. In the search bar, type wedding card and hit enter. Once the page loads, scroll down and pick a few that you like. For example, I think I liked this a lot. Even this looks good. Okay. Once you find a template that you like, edit the names, make a few changes like change the color, change the font, change the size, add some images if you want to. And once all that's done, your template should look something like this. Once you're done making all the changes, click on the share button, download, PNG or PDF is always suggested. Once you're done that, click on download and your beautiful wedding card is done. It's as simple as that. I use Canva for all my designing work. If you like Canva and want to start using it, I'll leave a link in the description below. Start creating. Okay, so once you've opened Canva, type Pinterest. These are all the pre-made templates which you can choose from. Take a quick look at it. You can check these out and if you like something, you can click on it and start using that. But for now, we are going to create our own Pinterest pin template. So we are going to start on a blank slate. The first thing to do is write your website name at the bottom of the pin. Once you're here and you've written the name of your website at the bottom, the next step is to look at all these pins and find out what you like the most. And then try to take that idea and generate it onto your Canva dashboard. Okay, that sounds simple. Let's go over this. What do I like from here? I like the fact that they are using multiple colors. Look at this. This is yellow and this is pink and this is black. What we understand is contrasting colors do well while creating a Pinterest pin template. In this Pinterest pin, what I can see is the number 7 is enlarged. We need to repeat the same process here. What this pin teaches me is to increase the font size of my website and to create a box around it so that it's highlighted. There's a slight design element here. It looks something like a square, but it has a design element to it. From this pin, what I learned right away is an arrow and it says legend. This arrow gives a lot of significance to the Pinterest pin and it shows the person who is viewing the pin that the entire thing is quite legit. So we are going to do something like that. This is what my final pin looks like. As we can see, the number is highlighted as shown in this Pinterest pin. This pin showed that there should be a square, which we have also incorporated here and here. This pin shows that a waviness is good for the Pinterest pin, and we have kind of created that right here. There's an arrow indicating simplified budgeting tips, which shows that whatever is in the article is quite simplified and easy to understand. When you start observing top performing pins in every niche, you start noticing some patterns in each of these pins. Like numerical is usually enlarged to show its emphasis, or contrasting colors are used to grab a user's attention. Another common thing you'll observe is the bottom of every single pin usually contains a website link. Contrasting colors, brand icon, website link, enlarged numericals, different fonts, different colors are some of these patterns that you should be observing in every single Pinterest pin. And these are the things you should try to create in your own pin. This is the final template I've created. It includes most of the elements that I've observed from all these 6 Pinterest pins. The enlarged number, the contrasting colors, the arrow which says something and grabs your attention, an image. Another thing you can do is change the fonts. Website link, although this is quite small, I'll probably enlarge it to 50. Yep. That's better. This is much better. You don't always have to put graphic images. You can also put stock photo images. But instead of using Google to find these images, you can use Canva's inbuilt library to find stock photos that suit your needs. Canva has a large library of free stock images for you to use at your disposal. If not Canva, you can always use websites like Pixel, Pexabay, and Unsplash. I'll leave links to these platforms in the description below. I don't have a specific pin template that I use because I like trying to do different things with new pins all the time. I keep experimenting small things here and there, so I don't really have a template in use. You don't need to have a Pinterest pin template ready at your disposal, but having a Pinterest pin template makes the process of creating pins much more faster and easier. We have created a template, but how are you going to use this to make pins for other blog posts? Let's say the next topic we're going to write on is 6 side hustles that make $1,000 per hour. Here's how we go about it. You can create Pinterest pins like this using the same template we used very easily. Let's say you want to replace it by an image. Let's say we do that here. We remove this, we remove these two also, and we add this image. There you go. 6 side hustles that make $1,000 per hour. There's an image that shows you the Pinterest pin looks quite attractive, and it only took me a minute to make it. That's the advantage of creating a Pinterest pin template. It's handy, it's quick, and there's no stress on how your Pinterest pin is going to look because it's always going to look good. Now that you know how to create a Pinterest pin template using Canva, I would recommend you watch this video next, where I'll be taking you through a simple 3-step process which most Pinterest marketers don't follow, but if they do, would boost their organic growth on Pinterest. That sounds exciting. Couldn't agree more.